Hello and welcome to this course on Thinking Functionally in Scala. Scala is a high-performance general-purpose programming language which supports both object-oriented and functional programming and which runs atop the JVM platform, that's the Java Virtual Machine. We'll begin this module by introducing Scala, and we'll do so particularly for data professionals. Next up, we'll get started. We'll get Scala installed and run a few really simple Scala commands. And then we'll move on to the conceptual stuff. We will distinguish between expressions and statements and see why the distinction has some pretty profound implications for the way in which we program and architect our code. And after that, we'll turn to functional programming support, which in Scala is hiding in plain sight. We will consider, for instance, how functions are really just named reusable expressions. So, what is Scala? Well, Scala is a general purpose programming language just like Java. In fact, it runs on the JVM, causing a lot of folks to ask why yet another language that runs on the JVM is needed when Java serves its purpose so well. The answer, in a nutshell, is because our language determines our world. That is also the basis of a concept known as linguistic relativity, a rather arcane concept from psychology. Let's consider the same thought expressed in two different languages. Let's say that one of those languages is Hindi, which really originated in India or South Asia, where the climate is hot and tropical. Let's say that the other language used to express that same thought is English, which of course originated in Europe, more specifically in medieval England, where the climate was cold and temperate. Let's say that you were describing a person with a charming personality. The way in which you do so would differ quite starkly in these two languages. In Hindi, you would say something like, "It cooled my heart to see her." This would be colloquially completely appropriate. In English, on the other hand, it would make total sense for you to describe this person as a ray of sunshine. Notice how the idiom in each language corresponds to the type of climate that is sought after or that is comfortable in the geography where that language originated. Our language has been shaped by our thought, and our thoughts in turn are shaped by our language. This is as true in computer science as in psychology, and this is, in a nutshell, the whole reason for the existence of Scala. Remember again that Scala is specifically designed to be a language that runs atop the JVM, i.e. which can interoperate with Java, but also supports both functional and object-oriented programming. Let's also take here a moment to understand why Scala is so relevant for data professionals these days. Really, there are two common ways to build or architect a system. As their names would suggest, monolithic systems have single, large and expensive computers. Distributed systems tend to use a large number of relatively cheap machines and wire them all together. As data sets get larger and larger these days, distributed systems seem to be the way of the future. The vast majority of programmers have traditionally written code for monolithic systems, and this is why the object-oriented programming paradigm is so popular. A generation of programmers has been trained to conceptualize systems as consisting of interrelated classes and objects. But these days, functional programming is coming out of the confines of academia and is becoming extremely practical. That's because functional programming paradigms mesh very smoothly with a distributed system architecture. Perhaps the unique appeal of Scala is that this is a language which appeals to programmers who have cut their teeth on object-oriented Java, but also gets the job done on distributed systems because of its functional support. As in psychology, our language shapes our thought, and the Scala language lends itself extremely well to working with distributed systems. The first such language design choice is support for functions as first-class entities. Functions in Scala can be passed into or returned from functions. You can basically do anything with a function in Scala that you could do with an object in Java. And that's essential for function composition, i.e. the chaining of functions with long chains of functions that call other functions. This is the telltale characteristic of functional code. If you work with a spreadsheet program such as Microsoft Excel, you can think of long nested formulae. that represents function composition, and many experts opine that Microsoft Excel is in its own way a nice little functional programming environment. Functional languages tend to heavily favor immutable data because this allows the use of functions without having to worry about inadvertently introduced side effects. The idea of immutable data exists in Java as well, by the way. You can simply mark a variable as final. But in Scala, immutable data is the norm rather than the exception. Pure functions have no side effects. The same output will result from running the code with the same input parameters. And when you put all of these features together, what you get is ease of parallelism. Notice how immutable data and pure functions, when combined, lead to code that is inherently thread safe. And code that is inherently thread safe is inherently easy to parallelize. We'll come back to this idea in a little bit when we talk about higher order functions. But really, the so what is clear. Scala straddles the object-oriented and the functional programming paradigms. And that's why Scala is so relevant these days for data professionals. And that's why it makes sense for every data professional to learn Scala today.